Welcome to the Barker Podcast Collection.
Welcome to the Not Watching Podcast. My name's Rob Howard, and this week I'm joined by
Ian Bruce,
John Marson,
and Marcus Hurley.
You can contact us on email at notwatchingpodcast@gmail.com or follow us on Twitter at notwatchingpod. Right, so movie news. Sadly, many people have died since we last recorded. Most recently, Patrick Macnee passed away. He was like 93, though.
Jesus.
Yeah, Patrick Macnee was known mostly as the main role, John Steed, in the Avengers. Before the Marvel Avengers, there was actually...
There was a decent set of Avengers.
The British Avengers.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he was. He did a lot of work during the years after that. Lots of TV stuff, but yeah.
He will be fondly remembered for the Avengers, definitely.
Yeah. Absolutely. Okay, moving swiftly on, also, probably most tragically, was the death of James Horner, who, whether you consciously know or not, was responsible for some of the most amazing music.
Titanic soundtrack, film music. That's one of my favourite soundtracks, have to admit. Not ashamed to admit.
Aliens.
That. Yep. He did some good shit.
Absolutely. But yeah, he was piloting an aircraft, wasn't he, and crashed it.
People in Hollywood need to stop flying fucking
planes.
I know.
Only do
it's awful.
With Indiana Jones on board.
Yeah.
Yeah, he seems to get
like
out
Gary
of it.
Scrap.
Yeah, 61 he was, died flying a plane in California.
Yeah.
Awful.
Did the plane crash, or did you just happen to be flying a plane when he died?
It crashed.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. I think there was a malfunction or something, but yeah. Wow. Anyway, yeah, he will be missed. But most of all, the passing of Sir Christopher Lee. I mean, he definitely lived a full life. It's no less tragic that he's not with us anymore. But yeah, what a body of work. 300 films?
Yeah.
That's quite impressive, isn't it?
And something like that.
I think there are films he's been in that haven't come out yet as well, so there's still more to be released with him in.
Yeah, it's quite often the case when they go like this.
Hmm.
But yeah, any particular memorable Christopher Lee roles?
The Hammer stuff he did in the 70s. Yeah. I didn't watch all of them in the 70s, although I could have watched some of them, I guess. But he was always... it was a weird old thing, the old Hammer movies, but he certainly made a few bucks out of it, I think.
Oh. And also Scaramanga.
Yeah.
He was quite cheeky and devious. He was. I always thought he was kind of like an anti-Bond in that.
Yeah.
Before they decided to try that idea with a few of them. You know, he was the first sort of... He had his own gadgets, he had his own assembling gun out of various bits and pieces.
It was like he was an equal villain for him.
Yeah.
He was the first person that made me realise me having three nipples wasn't a weird thing. I haven't really got three.
I did not know that. Oh.
Damn it.
Well, that really freaked me out. But it's not a weird thing, according to
Christian
Lee.
I was about to say, this podcast is all about freedom and, you know, equality and everything, so welcome.
It's the Rainbow Podcast.
We are an equal opportunities podcast. the man with the golden gun, indeed. I thought his depiction of Saruman was amazing.
Yeah.
Count Dooku, one of the only people in Star Wars to get to fight Yoda.
Yeah.
At least have his face on the person that was fighting the...
Yeah, there is that, yeah. But yeah.
And of course, he served his country as well as an RAF intelligence.
And he was SIS as well, or SBS, wasn't he?
He was a Nazi hunter after it was all
arrested.
He hunted down, hunted down the war criminals.
Awesome.
It's amazing. You kind of think he's done so much. And then, well, I actually did meet him once. I was at a convention, and he, you know, normally you have to queue up for ages. I think it was a London Film and Comic Convention. I was like, years ago. And he walked past, and he had all his minders and stuff, and he dropped something, and I picked it up for him. And he stopped, and he shook my hand, and I was just like, wow.
Because
he's done so many films, and he just seemed like a humble, quite a humble old guy. He was just
he was still making metal, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, he did some heavy metal Christmas albums.
Yeah.
And him as like as Dracula is probably the quintessential Dracula.
Yeah.
I don't think there's been a better depiction of him since then.
No, not at all.
That might have been one of his first roles as well.
Well, it was certainly one of his most famous earlier roles. I mean, if you go right down to his IMDb is ridiculous.
I've just googled it, and yeah, it was 1958, and that was his first appearance as Dracula.
Cool.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Even
also,
Jesus.
No.
He was Edward Woodward in The Wicker Man, right? As well, I think that was.
He was.
Was that his character?
No, Edward Woodward was someone else.
He was the baddie in that, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
In the original one, not the.
Oh no, that's the Wicker Tree. What the hell?
No, the Wicker Man he was in. He was definitely in the Wicker Man.
Oh. Are you thinking of Nicolas Cage?
Please don't think of that.
No, Edward Woodward was the policeman.
Yeah, and
in the Wicker Man,
it wasn't Christopher Lee. He was the head poncho of the whatever.
Yeah,
it was,
he was the guy in charge of the island or whatever he was. Yeah, I can't remember.
Yeah, I clearly don't know my shit where that's concerned.
It's a good film. That's a good film.
He was Lord Summerisle. Sorry, yes. I know. I need to see that. I still haven't seen it.
Wow, he was in everything. Oh my god. He was in a show called The Tomorrow People, which I watched as a kid in 95.
Who's fucking Saruman?
He was the voice of Death in Weird Sisters, the Terry Pratchett adaptation. epic win. He definitely won at life, I think. And
although,
what a present.
Sadly, eventually, he lost, as we all will. There you go. Happy thoughts for the evening.
Well, you know, he finished it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Well, it's always.
I always think if you go peacefully, then you've done it right. You know, it's not a bad way to end it.
I think if you go and people are having this conversation about you, you've done all right as well.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh, well, on that happy thought. there's been some talk of Top Gun 2. This has been long in development, and it's yet another 80s movie to be remade. But yeah, it looks like it's only going to happen if Tom Cruise is going to do it as Maverick. So,
well, I don't think it's going to be a remake. I think it's going to be
a sequel, isn't it?
Because the sequel's been bouncing around for ages.
The drone idea
is going to be just as homoerotic, though. I mean, like that film was proper.
It was,
queer.
You could ride my tail.
Crossing the swords movie.
Yeah, you can ride my tail any day.
It was where bromance was born. It was just.
Hey, let's play some beach volleyball.
There were no rainbows in the world until that movie.
I bet a lot of young men had a pivotal moment of self discovery after watching that film.
They learned how to high five anyway.
Yeah,
but this script's been kicking around for years, hasn't it? The drones one.
Yeah.
That's right. That's what it's going to
be. It's all over the news and shit. Oh, he's going to be doing this and stuff. Hold on, it was many years ago this was touted.
Yeah.
It's because it's all part of the Terminator press show. The producer of that, David Ellison, is working on bringing Top Gun back. He said, there is an amazing role for Maverick in the movie, and there is no Top Gun without Maverick, and it is going to be Maverick playing Maverick.
That makes sense.
Okay.
Doesn't mean Tom Cruise playing Maverick, but
yes, I think that's what he means. Yeah.
But I think the whole point, though, I mean, it kind of makes sense. I mean, Iron Man, kind of the first Iron Man film, touched on it as well, and the idea, the script originally came from the idea that the US Air Force are using these unmanned drones and they don't have the instincts of a pilot. And this was an actual story, you know, real news and everything else, and the idea that the Air Force funding would be cut. So that's probably where the idea of the original sequel came from. And it has, like Ian said, just been bouncing around for probably a while, nearly a decade since then, even.
It's probably as long as Fury Road was, to be honest.
Yeah, maybe, yeah, because that was rumoured for a long time, wasn't it? Which probably explains why there isn't a... Sorry, go on.
If the idea was to, you know, make a follow-up while Top Gun was still in the public popular consciousness, then, yeah, I guess it would have been kicking around for at least 30
years. The drones plot that's been kicking around for a while, specifically the drones plot.
Oh, okay.
On a side note, there's another film, I don't think it was in the listing, that was announced. I think we might have mentioned it in the previous one, Independence Day 2.
It's not called that, of course.
That's
it's
got
called
a
Independence Day. What is it called?
ID Forever or something like that. I don't know. Actually, no, that was the working one. I'm not sure what. No, that was the other one. That was the working title for the past 20 years.
It's called Independence Day Resurgence.
Okay.
Yeah, that was it.
Because they needed a different verb to use.
Revengeance.
We're running out of verbs.
Revengeresurgence or something like that. Yeah,
yeah, that one hasn't been used.
It's because it sounds like insurgents and people don't like them.
Independence Days.
One of the guys from Empire was on the set, and he said that it's the scale of the film is enormous.
Independence Week. The first one.
Yep. Yeah, he said he makes the first one look like, you know,
the piece of shit that it was.
No, it was a bit ridiculous, but I wonder if Apple are going to crack the virus this time as well.
Well, no, the big problem, apart from the fact that it's going to be America saving the universe again, is that was supposed the mothership they nuked was supposed to have been all of them. They travel from planet to planet research. And the idea is that they sent a beacon back and it's been taking 20, 30 years, whatever, to reach the rest of them. And they've been travelling this whole time. That is, as far as I know, the plot.
I've got to say, this is my prediction for this film, having seen nothing about it, is that Will Smith will now be the president.
He's not in it.
I thought he was in it.
No.
Oh.
No, Jeff Goldblum's in it. Will Smith asked for more money and they said no, fuck off.
Bill Pullman's in it.
I reckon Jamie Foxx will play Will Smith.
Wow.
Jesse Jeff.
So moving on, we've got we do have a new Spider-Man. It's been announced that Tom Holland will play the role of
I love it when they reboot Spider-Man.
Yeah, they've not done that for a while, haven't they? Mm.
They have said though that this is not going to be another like origin story. He's first going to be seen in Captain America Civil War, from then on. I did hear something about what the next film's going to be. I think he's playing like a young Peter Parker though, so. Yeah, I'm interested in how that's going to work after the events of Civil War.
I've got to be honest, the only comic book thing that I give a shit about at the moment is Preacher coming out as a TV show, which is we've heard a little bit about. But yeah, I don't know.
There's not much news about this.
There was a teaser trailer for Civil War leaked today.
Oh, really?
Somebody had a wobble cam copy of it from a screening at Comic-Con or SDCC or whatever at the moment. Some big thing.
It's not San Diego Comic-Con at the moment, is it?
No, there was a press event and, well, I say press, there were a lot of screaming fanboys in there and they showed like a 30-second teaser of the Civil War stuff. No Spider-Man. Some fighting. Chris Evans looking pouty and buff. Yeah.
Marvel aren't at Comic-Con this year, apparently. So that'll be interesting to see when they'll probably have their own event.
Too busy counting their monies.
While we're talking about comic book stuff, though, Ron Perlman apparently has been teasing Hellboy 3.
Excellent.
This has been everyone's been wanting this film to happen for ages.
Is it Del Toro? Do we know?
It won't happen without him.
I don't know. No.
Well, Well, I don't know, wouldn't it? If there's money in it, they'd do it.
I think so, but I think there are other properties that are more of a sure thing, and well, I wouldn't really trust anyone else to do it. I mean, I'm sure there are other people that could do it, but it's just so Del Toro, that whole thing. It's so cool.
Do
you
know anything about the story yet? It's going to be from the comics, but...
No, he just put up a tweet that had a picture of him as Hellboy, and it said, lurking, waiting, and then poof, one more Roman numeral after the name as if by magic. Maybe they'll announce something at at Comic-Con. Back when they didn't think it was going to happen, Del Toro said the idea for it was to have Hellboy finally come to terms with the fact that his destiny, his inevitable destiny, is to become the beast of the apocalypse, and having him and Liz face the sort of that part of his nature, and he has to do it in order to be able to ironically vanquish the foe that he has to face in the third film. He has to become the best of the apocalypse to be able to defend humanity, but at the same time he has to become a much darker being. That's what
That's all been done in the comics, obviously. I mean, it's an obvious storyline for the character.
Yeah.
But those are some of the best comics.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I can't if they do it, I'll be well happy.
To be honest, I mean, Del Toro, he was, I mean, jumping across podcasts a little bit, but he was involved in the Silent Hills with Hideo Kojima, and that's all gone up in smoke. So I don't know if he's working on anything at the moment.
Well, he's got his new horror film coming out, and then he's got...
Oh, yeah.
Has he?
And then Pacific Rim 2 has been greenlit.
Pacific Rim.
What's the horror film called again?
We've talked about it on here before, but I can't quite remember.
Me neither.
Pacific Rim Resurgence.
Pacific Rimmer.
No, it's called Crimson Peak.
That's it, Crimson Peak.
Crimson Peak and the Pacific Rimmer.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
That's going to be good.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Tom Hiddleston and Mia Wachowski, I think, Jessica Chastain, Charlie Hunnam, because he's, like, going to be in every film now. He's like the new Ron Perlman. Okay, and finally, as far as movie news goes, this Uwe Boll meltdown was just incredible. Have any of you seen this?
I don't even want to give him any credit by watching it. He's toxic. Sad news to hear.
Had to watch it.
Okay.
Yeah, basically, he was trying to get a film crowdfunded, and it didn't meet its goal. So he just put up a video on YouTube saying to all the people that didn't back him, "Go fuck yourself."
Wow.
I'll actually insert some audio of it here.
Okay.
So here's Uwe Boll, and that is the last update. We have only 4 days to do with the Rampage campaign. And that was my third campaign now, after Postal 2 failed, after Indiegogo for Rampage 3 failed, and now Kickstarter failed too. And basically my message is, fuck yourself, because that is so fucking absurd. What retarded amateur idiots collecting money on that absurd website, you know? We get approached by people like Kickstarter, do it, and you have hundreds, thousands of people contacting you to make a fast dime to say, I can push your campaign and I get 10% of whatever you collect, and it's all fucking bullshit, and I will never do it in my life again. For me, crowdfunding is absolutely dead. Goodbye. And it looks like nobody gives a shit about Rampage 3, so maybe I shouldn't do it then. I have enough money to play golf till I'm dead. And I was willing to do all of this as the campaigns to make any money. I want to do Rampage 3 because it is an important movie. But it looks like you're easier giving $600,000 if you make a movie about some retarded wizard in the forest, or for another whatever Marvel Avengers bullshit dirt. So goodbye, and goodbye Hollywood.
To be frank, I would fuck myself, but I'm too busy watching good films. So he can go and fuck himself and go and play in a railway track, really. I mean, that would be nice. Just toxic.
Maybe if
you had a Sense8 kind of connection with other people, that would be possible.
Oh, God. Yeah, so sorry to leave it on a downer. Start with a downer and leave with a downer for even... not even worth talking about, type way. But anyway, yeah, that's that. This has been the Not Watching Podcast in partnership with notlistening.co.uk. You can contact us on email at notwatchingpodcast@gmail.com. Follow us on Twitter at notwatchingpod. You can find the show notes for this show at notlistening.co.uk. And if you're listening to us on iTunes, then please do give us a review. Anyway, that's all for now. Thanks for listening. See ya.